Hi everyone, so welcome back to the second part, second day of Discover Impactional Shoot. I'm super excited for today, like seriously.
Yes.
So we are going to start in a few minutes, but by the way, my partner just looking gorgeous right there.
My partner as well. Wow, Lucas, why are we wearing red today?
Bestie.
Bestie vibes only.
Sorry, the lighting here is kind of... Wow.
It's okay. We don't mind that. Wow, Lucas, it's like so many of you guys are in the meeting room already. So welcome to those of you who has just joined or... You guys who are on the live stream, welcome. Hope you have a great time with Impactional today. Yay.
By the way, all of the participants also looking gorgeous right now.
Yes, definitely.
Who's not looking gorgeous? Like, we all are part of Impactional and no one in Impactional is ugly.
Yes. So. Everyone here looking good, so fresh. Wow. Wow, I can see here that similar faces as yesterday and new faces as well. So welcome. Thank you so much for coming. And we would like to also remind you guys to write your full names, rename your names with your full names like mine. My name is Annabelle, but I write it as Brigitta Annabella as well as Lucas. Okay, we're going to start in a few minutes. So you better prepare yourself for some fun today. It's okay, Sylvie. You can still write your name, Sylvie. Okay, for those of you who haven't like turned on your cameras, please do turn it on because we want to see your beautiful faces, your handsome faces as well. Don't be insecure, guys. This is a safe place for everyone, okay? Wow, I can see new faces here. We're so excited, right, Lucas?
I'm just fixing my lighting so it will be better and looks a little bit more handsome.
But you're already so good looking. Hello.
Hallelujah.
What do you want to look like again? Okay.
Guys, take your time. Maybe you have like some requests for the songs. You just drop it on the chat box, maybe.
Yes.
Play the song.
Right.
Can we play like K-pop? Oh no, sorry, kidding.
Oh, so you like K-pop? Oh, that's good though. I love K-pop as well. Okay. Someone said Brutal by Olivia Rodrigo. So DJ, you baby can play.
Okay, some like set girls, set boy vibes over here.
Yes, don't Olivia be sad, Rodrigo. Guys. Yes, because today we're going to have some fun. Okay.
So take your time, guys, because we are going to having so much fun today. It is obviously like yesterday was amazing, but today we guarantee to you that it will be awesome also.
Yes. Okay, I want to remind you guys again. Yes, Lucas. Maybe you can remind them.
Okay.
About renaming their names.
I'm going to remind you again, guys. Like, oh my gosh. Seriously, like, rename your name into your full name and then use the virtual background that we gave to you before. If you can, we expected and encourage you guys to use the virtual background. So like, if you can, then let's use the virtual background and open your camera, guys.
Yes.
Also, keep smile because we are doing so much fun today.
Yes.
With Annabelle and I again. Hi.
Hi everyone, hope you're doing well. Oh wow, we're about to start in a minute, so you guys prepare yourself, be comfortable, open your cameras because we want to see your good looking faces, okay? Because we really want to get to know each of every one of you here, right Lucas?
Yes, Annabelle. So take your time, guys, because we are going to start in a few minutes. It's brutal out here. I'm sorry. And volume is on. It's brutal out here.
Okay. So it's 3:05 already. I think we're just gonna start.
Okay, we are going to start right now. 1, 2, 3.
Hello
everyone.
Welcome. Woo!
I'm super excited for today.
Super excited. Yes.
Mm-hmm. First of all, we would like to welcome all of you guys. Welcome back to the second part of Discover
Impactional.
Only by Impactional. Use your reaction feature, guys. Like, clap your hands with those reaction feature. Give us so much love, like the love that we did yesterday. Seriously.
Okay. Yes, hype them up, guys. Oh. The comment section is like blowing up right now. And also hello for those of you watching through YouTube. You can also like comment down below.
Yes,
we're comment so excited there. And we're so happy to have you all here.
Maybe all of the participants on the Zoom right now, you can rate from 1 to 10 how excited you guys are. Seriously, just type it to the spam thing. Seriously. Okay. Oh, you guys made my day, actually.
Wow, it's blowing up. It's literally blowing off. Oh my, thank you so much, guys. We're so happy to be back here with you guys. As you guys know, new day, new surprise. It's the day 2 of Discover Impactional Youth. So good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. Welcome once again. And so, Lucas, can you actually like tell what is actually Impactional about, like the aims, the objectives, in case most of us didn't know yet?
Okay, bestie. So in case there are several of you guys that haven't joined our previous Discover Impactional Youth, I just want to like give like a general explanation. So Impactional is like a global international, like global community that we aim and have a dream together, all of the brightest and also like most potential youth from all over the world, which is we want to broaden this youth's knowledge regarding in like international education. We want to like give exposure about various cultures around the world. And also obviously we want to like successful one of the SDGs point, which is about the education. Isn't it sounds cool, Annabelle?
Wow, that sounds incredible. Thank you, Lucas, for like sharing about the general information about Impactional. So yes, Impactional is a global youth community which aims to achieve the SDGs and form a multicultural environment across borders. That's why we have more than 10 countries all together in this Zoom meeting right now, and we're just so excited. So Lucas, what is actually DIY about? Because we're like, we don't know what we are going to do today.
Okay, that's a good point. I like this kind of question. So guys, I think all of you guys already know Impactional from Instagram. So you guys know like our project, like the takeover thing. So if I can tell, this is like the continuation of taking over project that we did in our Instagram. However, the difference is like here you guys can interact directly with all of our ambassadors. So it will be going like usually you guys only like reply to the stories on the Instagram, but today you're going to interact directly. You can ask any questions directly, play the games together with all of our ambassadors, and it will be so fun. Super fun, Annabelle. That's all I can say.
Wow, that sounds amazing. So we can have a direct interaction with our beloved ambassadors and we can actually make friends after. Wow, that's super amazing. So Lucas, what are we going to do next?
Okay, everyone, before we are going to the next level of today's DIY.
Were you singing?
Also, sorry, I'm a fanboy, so.
Oh my, okay, Aspa fan.
Before we are going to the next agenda, of course, we have several rules for all of the participants to obey. So guys, we want like you guys to pay attention to us because Annabelle and I going to explain the rules for today's DIY. Go ahead, Annabelle. Okay.
All right, so these are the rules that we have to obey. As you can see from the screen, we have to rename ourselves into our full name if you haven't. Like my name, I am Annabelle, but I insert my full name as Brigitta Annabella as well as Lucas. And Lucas, maybe you can like read the second.
Okay, guys. So the second one, we encourage you guys to turn all of your camera on because we want to like see your beautiful faces like directly. Like how come you come to this, like how come you like join this event and you want to meet our ambassadors, but you're not turn your camera on. How come? So that is why, yes. Turn your camera on, guys.
Yes, don't be insecure, guys. Just make yourself comfortable, okay? And don't forget to use your virtual background that was given on the Telegram or the WhatsApp group because we're gonna take lots of pictures. And you guys know that the background here, the design is very cool. So thanks also to our designers because, wow, this is going to be amazing. Right, Lucas?
Of course, Annabelle. So we encourage all of you guys to use like the virtual background that has been given before in the groups.
Yes. And
the next one is we expected you guys to stay muted throughout the event unless you've been asked to open your microphone. So what's the next, Annabelle?
Okay, so next, we also encourage you guys to keep the chat box appropriate and respectful, and also be responsible and do not spam the chat box with things unrelated to the event so that the event may run smoothly. Okay, what's next, Lucas?
Okay, this is the last one before we are going to like most exciting part of today's DIY. So for all of you guys, if you guys have any inquiries of any questions regarding DIY, you guys can private chat all of our EO team with like a name like you can see on the screen, like EO underscore their name. So do not hesitate to ask them any questions. That is all the rules for today, Annabelle.
Yay! Oh, wow. Are you guys ready?
Okay.
For our main agenda, can you guys guess who are going to like give presentation today?
Annabelle.
Okay, what, Lucas?
How about we are taking picture first before we reveal
Yeah. We can actually do it. Okay, guys. So first of all, we're going to take pictures with our beloved ambassadors. It will be conducted by our team. Okay, team, you can actually like start.
Hello. I'm going to help you guys to take your guys' picture. Please, are you guys ready? I'm gonna count 1, 2.
Yes, we are.
And okay, wait a second. Let's do that again because we have like a lot of participants here. 1, 2. Okay, next slide. 1, 2. Awesome. Okay, another slide. 1, 2. All right. I believe that's all. Thank you so much, MC. And the floor is yours.
Thank you, Shakira.
Thank you so much, Shakira. Okay, moving on to the next session.
Okay.
Okay, Lucas, what are we going to do next?
Okay, I am not ready. The PPT said, are you guys ready? And I am not ready, actually.
Why? Why are you not ready?
we are going to reveal who's the first ambassador for the second day of today's Taiwan.
It's gonna be lit.
Guys.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Without further ado, let's just...
Who's the ambassador?
Okay, since every one of you here are like, you cannot wait, right? You can actually guess who will we have after this. Mm-hmm. Can you guys guess?
Is there any clue, like, seriously, because we have no idea?
Germany and New America. No, it's not actually America.
Okay, they get it right. Germany and New Zealand. So, Annabelle, now reveal who's the very first one.
Okay, so right now, without further ado, we're just gonna call our beloved ambassador, Gypsy Rose from New Zealand. Yay! Welcome, Gypsy!
Guys, show Gypsy lots of love. Use your reaction feature there. Hi, Gypsy.
Hi, Gypsy.
Okay, Gypsy. You can start, girl.
You can unmute yourself. Wow, Gypsy, your fans are like blowing off the chat section, you know?
Yes, they all like, come on, Gypsy, come on, where are you?
Sorry, it wasn't letting me unmute myself.
Wow, hi, Gypsy, we can hear you. We can hear you now.
Okay, hi, everyone. Yours, girl. Hi, good evening, good morning, good afternoon. Welcome, everyone. My name is Gypsy Rose, and I am the Impactional Ambassador from Aotearoa, New Zealand. So, a little bit about me. I'm 19 years old. I'm the youngest of three siblings. I have an older sister and an older brother. My first language is Māori, which is the indigenous language of New Zealand. I'm currently studying at the University of Wellington, Te Herenga Waka, in Wellington, the capital city of New Zealand. I'm doing a Bachelor of Arts, double major in anthropology and religious studies. I did a student exchange in Sweden with AFS 2019 to 2020. Next. So, New Zealand, Aotearoa. Aotearoa is the Māori name given to New Zealand, and the translation of Aotearoa means the land of the long white cloud. New Zealand consists of two main islands, the North Island, Te Kau Māui, and the South Island, Te Waipounamu. English is the main language spoken in New Zealand. However, there are two official languages, which is Māori, the indigenous language, and New Zealand Sign Language. A little bit more about New Zealand is that we have a population of around 5 million. As I said before, the indigenous people, the native people of New Zealand, they are called Māori. I myself am proud to be Māori. We also consist of different iwi and hapu. Like the indigenous people have iwi and hapu, which are tribes and sub-tribes of New Zealand. We also have different regions within the tribes and sub-tribes. And some of them are called Waikato, Tainui, Te Aroha, Ngāpuhi, and so many more. Some more. So number one, Māori tangata whenua, which are the native people of New Zealand. As I said, kingitanga is the Māori kingi movement. So the Māori king movement, we have our own Māori king. Tāmoko, as you can see, number three, means the traditional tattoo. So males have a face tattoo and they've called matora. And we have number four, kapuhaka, which are war dancers. Super, super cool to watch. I highly recommend if you ever have seen rugby, the rugby team perform a haka before they play. So a little fun fact. Māori greeting, a haka, hungi, sorry. It's the pressing of a nose. This is when you meet Māori or Indigenous people when you come to New Zealand and you meet them for the first time. This is how we greet you. Also, we have Māori performing weaponry. So we have a poi, which are the two ball-like with strings. And then we have a taiaha, the big long stick. And then a tefa tefa, which is also a stick but with a wider flap. And then a patu. We also have a marae, the meeting house. Those are very, very cool to get to know your family and just spend time with loved ones. You can go there to have celebrations, weddings, funeral, a waka, a canoe, and that's how my people, we believe that we came to New Zealand. An awa, which is a river, and then a maunga, which is a mountain. Okay, fun fact number one. We are the first country to see the sun, specifically East Cape. Such a beautiful place. Three places to go if you do eventually come to New Zealand is Mount Hikuragi, which is in East Cape, East Cape Lighthouse, super beautiful, and Wainui Beach, as you can see on these photos. This is where the sun rises first. Okay, fun fact number two, we have one of the longest place names in the world. So bear with me, I'll say it slow for you all. Okay, it is called Taumata Whakatangi Hana Ko Au O Tamatia Turipu Ka Ka Pukimanga Horonuku Pōkai Whenua Ki Tana Tahu. Super long, right? But yeah, it is a beautiful place as well. Okay, fun fact number three. Kiwi doesn't just mean the fruit. So in New Zealand, a New Zealand citizen or a New Zealand person, we are called Kiwi. Our national bird or our national animal is also called a Kiwi bird. So you have to emphasize the bird at the end. And then we also have the Kiwi fruit. So in New Zealand, we don't call them kiwi because we have three types of kiwi. So we have to say kiwi fruit at the end. Okay, fun fact number four, we have the Waitomo Caves. And at the Waitomo Caves, you can see glowworms. These are the glowworms that are native to New Zealand. So they're only found in underground caves in New Zealand. It is super, super cool. I've been about twice. You can do so many different things like abseiling, go on tubes in the river with really cold water, but it's super, super worth it. You can also zip line and just take a walk around the beautiful scenery and caves. It's super, super fun. So highly recommend if you ever to come to New Zealand. I got you. I'll come with you. Can you shout? No. Okay, fun fact number five. The Hobbiton movie set. So if you don't know, I'll tell you now. The Hobbiton and the Lord of the Rings, if you're fans, were filmed in New Zealand. And this movie set is physically real. So in New Zealand, you can come, have fun, go to Hobbiton, have some really good food, take lots and lots of photos. You can even have breakfast or dinner, walk around. You can even go inside the houses that The Hobbiton was filmed in. Super cool. Okay, so this is interaction time. We're going to do some Māori tongue twisters.
Uh-huh, Gypsy. I guess to like make it like more exciting, let's just ask our participants here to play together with you. What do you think about it, Gypsy?
Yeah, I'd love to.
Ooh. Wow, this must be really fun. Okay, so for those of you who wants to play with Gypsy for the tongue twister in Maori, you can actually raise your hand.
Yes.
And we're gonna pick randomly for this one. So you're gonna be super lucky if we like choose you, okay?
Annabelle, maybe you can see which one that you're going to choose for play together with.
Okay, so let me just choose. So I think I'm gonna choose. Okay, let me just choose Nicole Natasha. Hi, girl. You can unmute yourself and introduce yourself. And we're gonna, and you can now play with Gypsy for the tongue twister.
Where is Nicole? Oh, there is Nicole.
Hello.
Hey,
have fun.
Hi, my name is Nicole. I'm from Indonesia. And first of all, I don't know how to pronounce Maori.
Oh, it's totally fine. It's totally fine. I'll talk you through it.
This is okay. Not the exam, bestie.
It'll be good fun. Good fun. Okay, we're gonna do the first one. Is that all right?
So Gypsy, okay, maybe
the one in red.
Maybe like Nicole can try the first one, and then for the second and third one, we're going to choose another participant.
Yeah, for sure. Sounds fun.
Yes.
Okay
you ready, Nicole?
Can choose one more, and Gypsy, you can choose one more. Okay, so there will be two more. So you guys can raise your hands because Lucas and Gypsy are going to choose the lucky ones today.
You're going to choose right now. So, okay, I'm going to choose. Wait.
Wow, there's like so many raising hands. Are you confused?
Yes, obviously. Seriously.
Okay. Lucas, have you found one yet?
I found this one. Wait a minute.
Make sure you guys smile because Lucas is like searching for the one with the brightest smile.
My eyes
smiling. Oh, your fingers are so cute. Okay.
This one, like Mikhail Fabian.
Hello, Mikhail.
Hello, everyone.
Okay,
so Jeff. Maybe you can choose for the third one.
Yes, Gypsy. Now it's your turn.
It's your turn, bestie.
Okay, there's so many.
How
yes.
excited all the participants are. So, Gypsy.
So enthusiastic.
Oh, it's too hard. Can someone else pick?
Yeah, you can pick anyone, Gypsy.
Yes,
come
on. One, maybe with the brightest face,
like
smile, or the ones who catch your eyes, the ones who catches your attention. Well, you guys must be super lucky for this one.
How about Diva?
Oh, Diva? Is Diva here?
Diva Adriana or who?
Yes, that one.
Okay.
Hi, Diva Adriana, are you here?
Hi, I'm here.
Okay, hi, so here, bestie. Have fun.
Okay, so Nicole going to like play the first one, and then Mikhail going to play the second one, and then the last one will be Diva. So Gypsy, you can lead the game now.
Woohoo!
Okay. So how this game works is a tongue twister, but in Maori. And what you're going to do is I will say the tongue twister first. And if you still don't get it, I'll say it one more time. And then what you do is repeat it three times. Cool?
Cool, Gypsy.
Okay. Nicole's first, right? Is it Nicole?
Nicole?
Yes, I'm here.
Okay, so the first one, I'll say it super slow. The first one goes, Turi we tai tai, turi we tau tau, kia tau, Jamal.
Turi wei tai tai turi wei to to kia tau kia tau kia mau.
Turi wei tai tai
turi wei to to kia tau kia mau. Turi wei tai tai turi wei to to kia tau kia mau.
Oh, beautiful. Natural.
How?
Wow, that was amazing, Nicole. Congratulations. So Nicole will get like 1 point for a gypsy for this game?
Yes.
Isn't it so cool?
You did awesome, Nicole. Wow. If I were to like do this tongue twister thing, I would like just lose directly because I cannot.
You guys don't want to see me try this one. So yeah, let's move on to the second one.
Okay. Thank you, Nicole, for participating.
Thank you so much.
So next we have...
Thank you as well.
Yay. Thank you. And now we have Mikhail.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, so I'll say it slow again. So this one is koya, pehoya, itoya, eteroya, kamoya, epoya, karere, kimokoya.
Okay, so I'm gonna try it.
Koya. Do you want me to repeat it if you want?
Maybe I'm just going to try it first.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
Okay, so koya te hoya itoya. Eteroya, kamoya, epoya, karere, kimokoya.
Yes, that's absolutely it. So, okay.
Koya te hoya, itoya, eteroya, kamoya, epoya, karere, kimokoya. And then one more time. Koya te hoya, itoya, eteroya, kamoya, epoya, karere, kimokoya.
Oh, excellent.
Thank you so much.
Another natural.
Seriously. Oh, Gypsy, thank you so much, Mikhail. It was amazing. First try. God.
Thank you so much.
Good job, Mikhail. There was like a beat, you know? Like,
I don't know. Gypsy.
Wow.
But for the next game, we make it like funnier. So it will be like faster.
Yeah.
So they have to repeat it, but faster.
I think so as well.
Maybe you can like repeat it faster. And Gypsy, maybe you can choose like the best winner from all three.
Yeah, maybe they can all do it once, but really fast.
Yes, you guys can actually do it once more. Okay, Difa. Now it's your turn.
Go, Gypsy.
Hello. Okay. So this one is a little bit difficult, but it should be okay. I believe in you. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. So this one, it goes kutu kutu, ketu ketu, tuku tuku, tukua, tonutia, kataku teko teko.
Oh, that's so hard.
You'll be fine. You got this. I believe in you.
Okay, I'll try. Kutu kutu ketu ketu tuku tuku takua tonutia kitaku teko teko.
Oh, beautiful.
Okay, I'll repeat it the second time. Kutu kutu ketu ketu tuku tuku takua tonutia kitaku teko teko.
Great.
I'll repeat the third time. Kutu kutu, ketu ketu, tuku tuku, takua, tonutia, kitaku, teko teko.
Oh, perfect. Super good, super good.
Wow.
Wow, even Gypsy said perfect. Wow, Difa. I think, Gypsy, you know, you can like invite everyone who have played before, like Nicole and Mikhail as well, so they can repeat. And you can choose the best one, and the fastest one can win the game.
Yes.
Ooh, it's going to be interesting. Okay, I think it's okay to start now, is it?
Yes. What?
why am I the one that's so nervous?
Why are you the one nervous? If I and Lucas were about to try, maybe our tongue will get slipped already, and it's going to be very embarrassing though. Okay, so you guys can just play now. Good luck to everyone. Woohoo!
Repeat it three times. Again. Like, no gaps. Faster.
Yeah.
Which one do you want to go first, Gypsy?
The same order. So Nicole first.
Okay, go Nicole.
Okay, I'll try. Three way tie tie, three way tau tau, kia tau, kia mau. Three way tie tie, three way tau tau, kia tau, kia mau. Three way tie tie, three way tau tau, kia tau, kia mau.
Wow. Wow.
How come? Okay.
No way, Josh dropped. Like, that was so cool. That was perfect. Okay, so maybe next we have Mikhail. And let's see who will do it better this time.
Oh my God. Okay, so I'll try my best. Ah, yeah, thank you. Okay, so Koya te hoya itoya eteroya, kamoya epoya, karere kimokoya. Koya te hoya itoya eteroya, kamoya epoya, karere kimokoya. Koya te hoya itoya eteroya, kamoya epoya, karere kimokoya.
Oh, wow. Oh my gosh, this is gonna be so hard. This is so good.
Okay, I'm speechless.
Wow, someone said on the chat box, like, Eminem could never. Like, we don't have a beat here. Like, it's so cool. It's awesome. Wow, good job, Mikhail. And maybe Diffa can, like, try for the last time before Gypsy can actually choose the winner.
Yes, before our misjudge Gypsy choose the winner.
Okay, so come on, Diffa.
Okay, everyone did so well, so I'm really nervous. Okay, kutu kutu, ketu ketu, tuku tuku, takua, tonyuita, kitaku, teko teko, kutu kutu, ketu ketu, tuku tuku, takua, tonyuita, kitaku, teko teko, kutu kutu, ketu ketu, tuku tuku, takua, tonyuita, kitaku, teko teko.
Wow. Everyone's wow. So fluent.
This is like so amazing.
Wow, you guys, that's just so awesome. Thank you guys for participating. And maybe Gypsy, you can actually choose the winner. Wow.
Oh, if my I gosh. Was, I this cannot. Is so hard.
Everyone here is so cool. Amazing.
Yes, before I choose the winner, thank you so very much for participating in this Maori tongue twister. You can be fluent in my language. Oh, it's super, super hard. But I think the winner is Nicole.
Woo! Woo, Nicole! Congratulations, girl! Wow, you did great. Everyone did great here, though. Like,
everyone did so great.
That was awesome. Thank you so much, Diffa, Mikhail, and Nicole for participating. Okay.
By the way, Annabelle, yes? For the, yes? The reward for Nicole as the winner, after this, there will be a Q&A session. So Nicole, you can ask any question directly to Gypsy. After this, there will be like Q&A session. So prepare your question, bestie.
Yes, bestie.
Okay, the game was super fun. Seriously, no dub, like no cap.
Okay. So we've come to the end of my presentation. So kupu o te rā, word of the day, ka kite, which means goodbye. And I shall leave you with a whakatauki, a Māori saying, nā ku te rauro, nā te rauro, ko rai te iwi, which means with your basket and my basket, the people will thrive. If you have any more questions, you can hit me up on my social media. My Instagram's down below. And thank you so much for listening to my presentations. Love you so much, guys. Mwah.
Ooh, thank you so much.
Thank you, beautiful. Thank you so much, Gypsy Rose. That was an amazing presentation, right, Lucas?
Guys, show your love to Gypsy. Like, seriously, use that reaction feature.
Yes, use that reaction. Give some love to Gypsy. Wow, that was amazing. It makes me feel like
I want Gypsy. The entire screen. Seriously. So, Gypsy, yes. Like, Gypsy, like, taught us, like, gave us, like, lots of insights, new insights, actually, like, I learned so much from you, Gypsy, actually, such a young age.
Yes, definitely.
I'm really, this one, Annabelle, like, the one that with nose, like, touch each other nose, like, I find it so cool.
That's so cool, that's so sweet. Okay, I really want to visit New Zealand.
I go there. Seriously.
Yes, totally. And guys, behind an amazing presentation, like, I know you guys are curious to know more about Gypsy and to know more about New Zealand. So you guys can actually drop your questions down below. But first of all, we would like to invite Nicole, because she won just now, so she got the VIP ticket to do this Q&A session with our beloved Gypsy Rose. So welcome back, Nicole. Hello.
But no worries, guys. The rest of you can still write down your question there. We still see you back.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Spam. Do the spam thing. Okay. Oh, we have Nicole already here. Sorry, bestie.
It's okay.
Okay, Gypsy, prepare yourself. The question is,
yes, prepare yourself, guys. And Nicole, you can actually you can actually introduce yourself and ask your questions directly to Gypsy right now. Yay, good luck.
Thank you. First of all, thank you for hosting this event. I'm really excited but also nervous. I'm Nicole, I'm from Indonesia, and my question for Gypsy is, how are the people there, and what cultures and traditions make you proud being a citizen there?
Okay, good question.
Thank you so much for your question. I guess New Zealand is a very diverse country. So we have a lot of different cultures, different traditions in New Zealand. So we are made up of New Zealand Europeans, and then there's the Maori. And then we have a lot of Pacific Islanders, so Polynesian people. So there's like Cook Islanders, Tongans, Fijians, Samoans, maybe some from Hawaii, I don't really know, but mainly from those countries. We also have some from like Tuvalu. I don't know if you've heard of that place, but yeah. And I guess the most proud thing to be a New Zealand citizen, I guess, is being able to represent my country, my culture, wear traditional clothing, Pounamu, which is a necklace, a green stone, and a tamoko. Fun fact about me, actually, I have a tamoko, which is a traditional tattoo. I have one on my leg. So yeah, I hope that answers your question.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you so
much. That's interesting. That's an interesting question. And wow, that's just so cool, right, Lucas?
Yes, Annabelle. By the way, Gypsy, like you mentioned Tuvalu before, like, I'm just curious, is like New Zealand close to Fiji Island? Or it is
actually far? Yes, I think we're quite close. We're closer to the Pacific Islands. So all the different islands around the Pacific, not just Australia. Yeah.
Oh my gosh, I'm good at geography, y'all. Oh.
Yes, you are good at geography because you earlier asked Gypsy, right? I know that. Okay.
Now it is time for us to choose another question.
Ooh, like, who's going to be the lucky one now? Okay, you guys
can see like five.
And Lucas is going to actually pick one, right, Lucas?
Okay. Okay, such an honor. Such an honor to pick a question for Gypsy. Prepare yourself. All the question on the chat box just so interesting, Gypsy. Okay, so
choose the best one, okay, Lucas?
Mm-hmm. By the way, guys, besides the chat box, like lots of interesting questions from the chat box, we also like receive lots of questions, like thousands of questions from like your registration form. So we also like really paying attention to those questions that you guys gave. So here, this one comes from...
Who is it?
Aminiel James Hobson.
Hi, Aminieli. Oh, he's there already. Hello.
Okay. Oh, sorry for pronouncing your name wrong. My mistake.
Well, you have a really nice name.
Gypsy, prepare yourself. Hi, Aminieli. Maybe you can introduce yourself, which country you're from, and then your question.
I'm sorry, Aminieli. We haven't actually heard. We cannot actually hear.
Can you guys hear me now?
Yes, we can hear you now. Okay.
No worries.
Have fun.
But hi, also Gypsy, thank you for the presentation. It was really awesome. My name's Aminieli. I'm from the Northeast part of the USA, but I'm also half African-American, half Tanzanian, which is pretty cool. And my question to you is, how's the education system in New Zealand? Is it any similar to your exchange experience by any chance?
Wow, that's a great question. Nice to meet you. Another Indigenous to another Indigenous. Great question. So the education system, how can I put this simple? So I went to Sweden, and Sweden's education system is totally different to the New Zealand education system. So in New Zealand, we have a Māori educational system and then a mainstream educational system. So in the Māori educational system, we have kōhanga reo, which is kindergarten, pretty much for babies right up to your 5, sometimes even 7. And then we have kura kaupapa, which is a Māori mainstream school where they only teach in Māori. Some of them go from ages 7 all the way up to ages 18. And then we have a whare kura, which is a high school for just Māori people. But non-Māori can go to that school as well if they want to learn the language. So that usually goes from year 9 to year 12, which I believe in America might be grade, to like freshman, junior, sophomore, and senior, I believe. Yeah. So that's the comparison, which is high school. And then in the mainstream, we also have primary school, and then we have intermediate, and then we have high school. And we also call high school in New Zealand college. So yeah, hopefully that answers your question.
That's awesome. Thank you so much.
Thank you for your question.
Thank you for your question, Aminieli. By the way, your name is so cool, and wow, you're a cool person as well. And the question is also interesting, right, Lucas?
The education system, like comparing between Gypsy's like experience during her exchange with the current situation education system in New Zealand, such a great question, actually. Thank you so much. Think
it's also so cool. Gypsy, thank you for your answer. Okay, so for the last questioner, as usual, we're gonna like choose the lucky winners. I mean, the lucky questioners.
Yes.
Okay, who is it? Have you found one?
I haven't, but everyone like, hi, Gypsy.
Yes, and everyone here on YouTube as well. Everyone is like asking and blowing up the comment section. Wow, guys. Thank you guys so much.
Ask For those of you who are watching from the YouTube live streaming, we're like, seriously, you guys, we notice you guys. So you guys
are the best.
Any question? But
okay. However,
is there any question that you find interesting already, Brigitta? I mean, Annabelle?
So maybe there are like a ton, there are like dozens. I'm so confused right now, but I found this one interesting. It's from Adenia. Hi Adenia, are you here?
Adenia.
Yes, I'm here.
Hi, bestie.
Hi.
So you are the lucky one here to like ask questions directly to Gypsy Rose. Okay, the stage is yours.
Okay, so first of all, thank you for choosing me. And my question is, how is the Maori culture within the community of New Zealand? Like, I know that not all people are Maori, so how does that go? How do they like go in with the community? I hope it's clear what my question is.
Yes, great question, great question. I love that question. So from my understanding, I believe that each New Zealander, not Maori, but New Zealander really, really enjoys being able to intertwine and be together with Maori. So there's so many different things that we do here in New Zealand that contribute to Maori and tangata whenua, the indigenous people of New Zealand. We have exhibitions, we have showcases, we have this thing called Te Mata Tini, which is a Maori festival for performing arts, so Kapahaka Festival, that goes every 2 years, I believe. So next year, 2022, there's going to be a Maori Kapahaka Festival, Te Mata Tini, which is the biggest Kapahaka Festival in the world. And, sorry, excuse me. And there, you can try all the different Maori food, any types of food in New Zealand, and just get to be amongst the Maori people. You get to listen to so many different stories, experience so many different things, see tāmoko up face to face. You can see Pounamu again, and you can experience so many different things and hear the language, beautiful singing, beautiful haka. And also we have this thing called Maori Language Week, which is coming up in September. We have a whole week filled with everything to do with Maori. So yeah, hopefully that answers your question.
Thank you so much for the answer. It did answer that. And it seems so interesting. Thank you.
Oh, that was amazing, that was so interesting, to be honest, Adenia. And I really want to become part of the community. That's just so cool, Gypsy. Thank you so much for the question and for all of you who have participated in this Q&A session. Right, Lucas?
Yes, Gypsy, what do you think about all of those questions and all of these participants that are just so excited for you? What do you think?
Oh my gosh, it's so overwhelming. I was looking at the chat and there's so many questions that I didn't get to answer, and I'm so, so sorry that I couldn't. But hopefully soon, I'm not hinting, hopefully I'm allowed to say this, but maybe in the future, I'll be doing a takeover on the Impactionals Instagram.
Yes,
so
please,
keep an eye
yes,
out.
Please. Girl, keep we're an waiting eye, for you.
And then I can answer all your questions there, but I'm so, so sorry that I couldn't answer any more questions. I love all of them. I tried to read all of them, but I couldn't. They just keep coming through. So I love you all. Thank you so much for the love and the questions.
Aww. And we love you too, Gypsy. We love you so much. Yes, guys, for those of you who actually haven't participated yet, are not lucky this time, you can actually like reach out to Gypsy in personal, because right now we're going to take off to another country.
So guys, Once again, thank you so much, Gypsy. Like, y'all, there, do this pump thing there. Like, say thank you, Gypsy, because she's
super. Give some love over on Instagram at gypsy.kateka. Okay. So, now, Lucas.
Yes.
What are we going to do after this? Like, I cannot wait.
I just bought a ticket. So, the ticket is... The ticket is gone. Sorry.
Why? But, why is it gone?
But I already have a plan to go there right now. And with all of you guys.
Interesting. Ooh. So, we're going to travel virtually.
Actually, this is like going to travel from like South Pole to the North Pole, actually.
Oh, wow. Okay. That sounds fun. Can you just like make it quick because I'm so excited for this one.
Oh, can you guys? Oh, actually, they already guessed who's our ambassador. So I'm not going to ask again because they are already super excited for this one.
Okay, everyone's so smart, right?
Yes. If... Gypsy never did the takeover before, but this one just did her very first takeover like a few days ago.
Wow, I'm so excited.
So all the way from the Germany, please welcome our German club ambassador, Michelle.
Okay, just welcome Michelle. Hello.
What's up? It's so insane how many people are here.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. How about you guys?
We're good as well, and we're so excited, actually. I'm so, like, pumped up right now. I'm so happy to see your face. You're so cute.
Oh, thank you. Okay. Okay, so I'm just going to get started. So, yeah, welcome to this amazing event. My name is Michelle Furman. I'm 17 years old, and I'm the ambassador for Germany. I did an exchange here in Seattle in the year 1920, and I'm currently... a senior after summer, so I'll be graduating. I'm scared because I'm not really sure what to do after. Probably most teenagers don't know. And now about the things I love. I love sushi. Write in the chat if you like sushi too. I love hanging out with my friends. I love hanging out with my family. I love traveling a lot, especially since I did my exchange here abroad. It's kind of my dream to in the future to have many possibilities to travel. And I love art. I also have in school, I have a class in art, so that's fun. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, so what is Germany? I'm going to give you a brief introduction about Germany. I thought a mind map would show it really nicely. Okay, first of all, about like the structure or the type of government Germany has. It's a democratic federal parliamentary republic, which is a super long name. In German, it's even longer. It's Demokratische Parlamentarische Bundesrepublik, super long. Then we have the capital is Berlin, maybe some people know. And our chancellor at the moment is Angela Merkel, but she's actually not going to be our chancellor anymore in October because we're going to have elections. We're going to have a new chancellor, which is kind of scary, but also I guess everyone is curious who's going to be the next person. We have 83 million inhabitants, which is a lot of people for such a small country as Germany because it's not as big as, for example, Indonesia. It's way smaller from space. And it consists of 16 states. So the United States have states and Germany has it too. And we call it Bundesländer. So yeah. All right, fun facts. Germans value and love their bread. When I was abroad in Seattle, they only had like really white toast bread, which was not really yummy, to be honest with you. So I was really sad because I really wanted to eat normal bread. So that's a really nice fun fact. Also, like there's a bakery at every corner, literally. And the bread is also really cheap. Like bread costs like 10 cents. So that's kind of cool. Okay, another fun fact. So Gypsy Rose has also talked about this in Maori. And it's the same in German. We have really, really long words. And I'm going to read them to you guys. So be ready. The first one is Rindfleischetikierungsüberwachungsaufgabenübertragungsgesetz, which is basically, it's literally a law, which is described in a word. It's about like marking special type of meat as a law. So like, it's insane. Okay, next one. Straßenverkehrsordnung, road traffic regulations, Geschwindigkeitsbegrenzung, speed limit, Kinderspielplatz, children's playground. And speaking of speed limit, to our next fun fact, we have highways that don't have speed limit. So maybe some people know, also a lot of people know that who love cars and love like racing and stuff. So there are literally highways where you don't have any speed limit. So you rely on the people, on the citizens. So yeah. And the next fun fact also about cars, because you know, we just all love cars, don't we? Germany invented the first automobile, 1886. Gottlieb Wilhelm Daimler and his partner, Wilhelm Maybach, created the first four-wheeled, four-stroke engine known as Kanscha Daimler. So, like, who of you guys is, like, into automobiles? Write it down. Like, what's your favorite brand and stuff? So, yeah, that was the fun facts. And the fifth fun fact is about football, obviously, because you know, Germans love their football too. So DFB is the German Football Association and has the most members of all the football unions in the world, in total 7.1 million members, which is insane because it's so many people. Like, can you even imagine so many? I mean, it's already crazy that we're so many people here. So like, yeah. Okay, that was all the fun facts. And we're gonna get started with engaging time as well. So I think for the people who were there yesterday, Israel did the same game, but I'm gonna explain it anyways for everyone. So basically I'm gonna give you guys three facts and then there one of them is a lie and two are true. So you have to guess which one. So yeah.
Okay.
Oh, okay, Michelle. Okay.
I see Michelle face already like super excited for this one.
Yes. Okay, you guys are probably also already excited to play with Michelle. So for those of you who want to play, you can just raise your hand as usual. And Lucas and I are going to choose the best with the smiliest face. Okay, so there are like a lot of people here like raising their hands already.
Yes.
Okay.
I have to use my glasses, please.
Yes. Glasses. Okay, Lucas, that's a really great dedication. Okay, so the participants here, wow, everyone here wants to play like real quick. Okay, have you found one, Lucas?
Mm-hmm. Wait, give me a second. Michelle, be ready.
It's gonna be fun. Woo!
Okay, this one. Eugenia Agnes Lawerisa. Oh.
Hi, Eugenia.
Oh my God, hi.
Hi, we can hear you.
Okay, we're going to start with this one first, and then for the next, we're going to choose another one.
Okay. So good luck, Eugenia.
I'm gonna read them first and then you can, okay, is that a good idea? All right.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
Okay, the first one, the German Chancellor Angela Merkel is part of the Christian Democratic Union Party because we have like a party system. East Germany, zone occupied by the former Soviet Union, was called DDR. Before Germany was united in 1990, the capital of Germany was Frankfurt. So what do you think? It's not like, don't worry if it's wrong. Like literally, if it would be about another country, it would be wrong too. So like, don't worry about it.
Yeah. So I think the lie one is the German Chancellor Angela Merkel. I don't know how to pronounce her name correctly.
But it's okay. No worries.
Okay. Is part of the Christian Democratic Union Party. I guess that's the lie. I don't know.
That is sadly wrong. You can guess again, but no, she's actually part of the Christian Democratic Union Party, which is called CDU. So it's actually true. But now you have a 50% chance. So like,
oh, I really don't know though. Okay, I think I'm just gonna pick randomly the yellow one, I guess. The Eastern.
No.
Okay. I'm so wrong about this.
No, don't worry about it. Literally, it's fine. So yeah, actually, so the one is true. So it was called DDR. Germany was split into Western Germany and Eastern Germany, because when we lost the Second World War, a little history recap for everyone, when we lost World War II, Germany was split in half, basically, and one of the occupation zones was the former Soviet Union, the other three were the Western countries that won the war. So yeah. Oh yeah, the lie was before Germany was united in 1990, the capital of Germany was Frankfurt. Actually, the capital was Bonn, a city called Bonn, but Frankfurt was it almost. And I'm from Frankfurt, so I'm really proud of that fact. So yeah, but you did great. No worries, literally, it's fine.
I think I need to work on my history skills.
Don't worry about it, really, it's fine.
By the way, thank you, Eugenia. Like, seriously, this is not an exam. We're having fun here, isn't it, Michelle?
Yes, exactly. They clearly don't worry about it.
Good job, Eugenia. Thank you for participating on the game. Wow.
Yeah. Thank you for your enthusiasm.
Yes, no pressure. That's amazing. Okay.
I think I'm the one should be thankful because, like, I've just got the chance to talk to the ambassador. It's, like, very nervous.
Thank you, Eugenia.
Bestie, you're lucky today, and we're so happy to have you. And Michelle, too, right? She's, like, very excited. Everyone's, like, very excited. Okay, Lucas and Michelle, I think we're just gonna choose another participant to, like, play the game.
Yes. Just choose one.
Okay, okay, let's just give it to Michelle. Michelle, you can actually choose the ones you actually want.
Okay.
Wow, this person must be really lucky.
Yes, guys. Like, this seriously. No pressure here.
Raise your hands, guys. Michelle's gonna pick. Sure, best man.
If I'm one of you. I don't know if I can give.
I'm gonna go with Nisia.
Who?
I think. I don't know if I pronounced it right. I'm sorry if I didn't.
Okay, Nisia, you can actually unmute yourself. And introduce yourself.
Where is she?
Are you here?
Nisia.
Is it me?
Is this one, Michelle?
Wait, I didn't see her face. Oh, no. Oh, but you can do it.
Okay.
No, but it's okay. It's okay. Don't worry.
No problem.
Yeah, no worries, Rizkia. Okay, maybe we're going to go with Rizkia first.
Yeah, it's fine. No worries.
Okay. Have fun.
Okay. Hello. So I'm going to read to you the facts again, and then you can guess the lie. But like before, don't worry about it if it's wrong. Okay, first fact. Frankfurt has the second biggest airport in Europe. Germany won Football World Cup 3 times. All stores are closed on Sunday. So.
I think the lie one is the yellow one, I guess.
Yes, that's correct. Are you a football fan? Are you into football?
Actually,
my God, literally go off. That was so good, though. Yeah, thank Germany won the Football World Cup 4 times, actually. So,
oh,
we'll flex here, no.
Okay.
But, yeah.
Like, seriously, if people don't know Germany's football team and how?
Yes.
Everyone
good
knows.
Good job, Rizkia. You're, like, very knowledgeable. I would say I was gonna say something else, so people would. I would just be so embarrassed, Lucas.
So Michelle, the third one is a fact, a truth.
Yeah, all stores are closed on Sundays. Yep, everything is closed. Like it's dead. Like you can't do anything. It's so bad. Also, today is Sunday. Oh yeah, today is Sunday. So everything is closed.
Everything
I can't
closed
do anything
right now.
Yeah.
Oh wow, interesting.
Oh, Olga wrote same in Poland. Yeah, okay. Because it's like Germany is still like kind of Christian, I guess. So like, yeah, even supermarket. So like,
You can like just have your holiday on Sundays. Yeah,
I guess. Yeah, it's like, I guess in Germany, it's like kind of a worship day. Like if you looking at it from a Christian perspective, it's like the day you go to church and stuff.
Yes.
New thing to learn again, seriously.
Yes, new things every day. Oh my. Oh, right now we're going to like choose the third one. So guys, raise your hands.
Annabelle.
Okay, there's a lot here. Yes.
You can choose one.
All right. Let me just choose quickly. Matthew Filbert. Okay, are you there?
Hi. Yeah, I'm here.
Hi.
Okay, he's so excited. He's looking super excited right there.
Wow, we're so excited. Okay, you may play with Michelle. Have fun.
Okay, hi, I'm
What's up, Matthew? What's up, Matthew? Thank you for participating. Okay, yeah. Let's get started. I'm going to read to you the facts again. You have to guess the lie. Okay, Germany has no border to a sea. In Germany, we call gloves hand shoes. Alcohol can be consumed and bought at the age of 16.
Okay, I guess the yellow one is the lie.
No, we literally call them hand shoes.
Oh, okay.
It's really literal here. Like,
let me.
But it's okay. You have 50-50% chance now.
Alcohol can be consumed and bought at the age of 16.
No.
Okay.
It's true. We can buy alcohol at the age of 16, but it's for beer and wine. So, but it's okay. Really, don't worry about it.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay. Yeah. So Germany has no borders to sea is a lie. We actually have a border to the North Sea and the Baltic Sea. It's really up in the north. So going to the beach and getting tan isn't really like working because it's really cold. Maybe you have like 2-3 days in summer that are fine, but yeah.
No worries, Matthew. Like, good try. Actually, Europe is like every single country in Europe, like so close to each other. So it is possible that if you think that Germany has no border to a sea, but actually Germany has border to sea. So you learn also to learn, isn't it, Matthew? Thank you so much.
Yeah, I think
Thank you, Matthew, for participating. Awesome.
Thank you. Oh, my background. Just okay. What are we going to do next?
Yeah, so that was my presentation, guys. Thank you so much for everyone who participated and spammed in the chat. I appreciate it a lot. Feel free to contact me anytime. So there are my socials, my number, my Instagram, and my mail. So if anyone wants to get in touch, I'm always here for it. So yeah.
Yay, thank you so much for the amazing presentation, Michelle. Isn't it great, Lucas? Like, yeah. I really want to fly to Germany right now.
Yeah, actually, I thought that Michelle will like give like a cooking class right now because she cooked a bread, like she made a bread before at our infectious takeover.
Really? Michelle, you're a baker? Oh wow.
No, I'm really bad at baking. I did it with my friend. We like it was fine. It was yummy though. Everyone can try it.
Wow. Yes. Oh my, that sounds delicious. You're so talented. Thank you so much, Michelle. And
you know what? Glad that our games and our engaging time with Michelle is not like the tongue twister, because can't you imagine if the longest words and then all the participants have to do it? Seriously.
Yes. Wow. That will be very crazy. Okay, so guys, maybe for those of you who are like wondering, is Michelle is really a baker? I want to see what Michelle cooks. If you want to see what she does, you can like visit our Instagram at Impactional, and you can see the ambassador takeover because Michelle has done it and it's super amazing. So thank you so much, Michelle, once again.
Thank you.
And now for all of you guys who wants to ask any questions to Michelle right now, right now. Oh my God. I like my words, like I haven't finished my words yet, but the questions, lots of questions already in the chat box.
Wow, everyone is so, like so enthusiastic for Michelle. Michelle, your fans are so many. Whoa. Okay. So we're just gonna choose the ones. with the best question. Okay.
Yes. So this question, like, we are going to choose the most interesting one. Michelle, what do you think so far while we are looking for the question? How do you feel? Really,
I feel overwhelmed because there's so many, like, questions. Yes.
Amazing. Okay, Michelle, I think I found one interesting question that you can answer.
Okay.
Okay, go. So it's from Fadil Abdillah. So Fadil Abdillah, you can actually unmute yourself, introduce yourself, and you can have a chit chat with Michelle. Okay. Are you here, Fadil?
Yes. Hello, Guan.
Hello, Fadil.
He's the one from yesterday. Awesome.
Yes.
What's up?
Hello, Michelle. Hi. It's an honor for me to say my question directly to you. So my question is, can you give us some German habits that other people might be able to do? My question.
German what? Can you repeat it?
German habits.
Okay. So for habits, I guess Germans are really organized and we're really structured. So like we want to have their order, which is sometimes also like perfectionist. I don't know the word, but yeah, you know what I mean. And also we're really punctual as a habit. So I feel like if you're late in Germany, that's not so good. And other than that, we're really direct and really like honest. So if we don't like something, we're really direct and honest, which is a great type of communication, because if you have a problem with someone, you can tell them directly. So that's kind of the habits. I hope that answered your question.
Okay, thank you, Michelle. That's a great answer.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Fadil. Seriously, like, Fadil, you're so lucky because yesterday Annabelle also pick you, and today, oh my god,
wow,
I'm starting to think like Annabelle.
Wow.
Annabelle, yeah, is there something between you and Fadil because you keep choosing him?
No, super not at all, but I saw the question is like very interesting.
Okay, I'm getting jealous right now, my partner looking for another partner.
You don't do that, Lucas, don't be bestie. Okay, thank you so much, Fadil, for actually like, you're so lucky, by the way. And okay, thank you so much. I think we just like, let's move on to another question. Yes. So drop your questions down below, guys.
Annabelle?
Yes?
I'm still mad at you, so let me choose the interesting one. Don't
be
right
mad.
Now.
Okay, fine. You can actually choose.
Okay. Let me looking for the best question. Give me a minute.
Let's choose the best, okay? The most unique question.
Okay, lots of questions. I have to see their name carefully. Okay, this one comes. Her name is Aurelia Gunawan.
Hi, Aurelia Gunawan.
Hi.
Hello.
Why she looks
am I audible? So
she looks like an Indonesian artist.
Okay, thank you so much for choosing me. I'm so nervous and happy. So first of all, thank you, Michelle, for your sharing today. It was so amazing and it was so fruitful. I get a lot of information, especially about Germany. And my question is it true that the tuition, I mean the fee for all of the universities there are free, like we don't have to pay anything for the tuition fee?
Okay, and that's a really good question. I also answered that question my takeover. First of all, thank you for participating, Aurelia. And the tuition is free indeed, but you have to pay like a little fee, which is like 200-300 euro, but there's no tuition generally, so yeah, but that's only for public universities. Private universities cost, so yeah.
Wow. It is amazing. Okay, thank you so much, Michelle and Annabelle and Lucas. Thank you so much.
Oh my gosh, you look so
Aurelia for participating. Woohoo! Wow, actually, Aurelia, you look so similar. Everyone here says that you look so similar to an Indonesian celebrity. Wow, the chat box is so cool.
A lot of my friends even told me that I'm similar with Cinta Kuya.
Wow, so Michelle, you can actually Google Cinta Kuya.
Yeah, I'm literally doing that right now. Oh my god, you look like her. Wait, you really look like her.
Oh my god.
Wow.
No, Michelle, it's different.
Even Michelle,
you look so much like her.
Yes, you're talking to a celebrity, Michelle. So a celebrity talking to a celebrity right now.
Oh no, not a celebrity.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Aurelia, for participating.
Mm-hmm.
And for the last question, I guess, Lucas.
Okay, now I'm going to give it to you, Annabelle, even though I'm still jealous with the one before.
Please don't be. You Lucas, can go you're ahead. Still like number one MC partner, you know? Like you're the best. Bestie. Okay.
This is going to be the last question for Michelle, isn't it, Annabelle?
Yes. So, this was going to be the last. So you must be really lucky this time. Okay, I think there is one interesting question from Hazelia Diva. So Hazelia Diva, you can actually unmute yourself and introduce yourself for your Q&A session with Michelle.
Hello. Oh my god, I'm so nervous. I'm shaking.
No, why are you nervous? I'm literally your age probably. Like, it's not...
There's so many people.
I know. I'm nervous too, so don't worry about it.
Okay, so let me introduce myself. My name is Hazelia Diva Alfredo, or Hazel. I'm from Indonesia and I'm 15. And my question is, because knowing that at Sundays, you say it was like the silent days for everyone, where all the shop is closed, also the supermarket. What happened if there's a celebration, like big celebration from other religion happen in that day as well? I mean, like, what will they do, or do they have rules so it's not going to be really loud or something like that? Thank you. Oh my god.
No problem. So you mean like if there's another, like, from, for example, if someone has another religion and they celebrate on that day something?
Celebration or big celebration like that.
I mean, you can, so Sundays, basically, it's kind of a day of silence, but it doesn't mean that you can't be allowed and celebrate. It's not like that. Just the stores are closed, basically. It's not like you are not allowed to, like, go on a party or something. And, like, it's literally the opposite. So, like, there's absolutely no problem. We have freedom of religion in Germany, so everyone can celebrate their religion. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you for the answer. Thank you for picking me as well.
Thank
you so much, Hazel.
You're welcome.
Okay. Thank you so much, Hazel. Wow. By the way, your name.
Thank you, Hazel. Your name is so cool. It's so nice. Okay, I think there is another interesting question here on the YouTube live.
Okay. So everyone on
YouTube, yes.
Everyone on YouTube also so excited, I guess.
Yes. Okay, so this one is from Sasha. Sasha, am I pronouncing it right? Okay, Sasha from Singapore asks, okay, is she here? Okay, she's not here, but
She's from the YouTube, bestie.
Yes. So she's asking you, Michelle, where do you know Impactional and why did you want to actually become an ambassador in Impactional? So she's watching now on YouTube.
Hi.
What's up? Thank you so much for your question. So how did I find out about Impactional? Actually, a really great friend of mine that I met in Seattle, her name is Kenda. I don't think she's here right now, but she's in the public relations team, I think, PR.
Our mama.
We love Kenda. She's a queen. Go follow her on Instagram. Okay, anyways. we have like a group chat out of like all the international people that I was in an exchange with in Seattle, and she sent a link in, and I was like, you know what, I want to do that, because I was actually in the United States with a scholarship that's called CYX, and I was also ambassador in the United States already, And also, like, in the future, I want to be an ambassador, like, in politics. So I want to be, like, a diplomat. But that's a really rough plan. So I guess, like, being an ambassador here means so much to me because I am representing my country. And also, like, if my term is over, I encourage everyone to apply because it's an awesome opportunity and it's really fun. So, yeah, that's kind of, like, the answer. Yeah.
How cool.
Wow, awesome. Thank you for the question, Sasha. And also for Michelle, thank you for the answers as well. Like, yes, Kenna is our PR mama. I think everyone knows Kenna in here.
So, Annabelle, like, seriously, like, Impact Channel is, like, full of an amazing people, amazing youth from all across the world. Michelle is one of them. And Gypsy before, obviously, also yes. One of them. And all of you guys here also, we are family, actually. All of the participants here also part
yes,
of
yes, guys. No. Everyone here are family. So welcome to Impactional. And thank you for Michelle and Gypsy for your amazing presentations. And right now, Lucas, we're going to do something very fun.
Okay, so very it is already the end of our session with Michelle. Thank you so much, bestie.
For those of you who actually wants to, like, ask personal questions, you may just check Michelle's Instagram. And yeah.
Give Michelle so much love, guys. Yes, like, I see your
so
face.
Much love.
Annabelle, I see their face, like, they are, like, so tired right now. Guys, yesterday is, like, night. We did the IY yesterday, like, 8 p.m. Indonesia time, but you guys still excited. And now, you guys, come on. So that is why, to, like, bring their smile back, we are going to have something fun today.
Some of you actually looks hungry. It's okay to actually eat. Like, make yourself comfortable here because Impact Channel is a safe place for everyone to become yourselves. So don't worry, guys. No worries. Please just eat. It's okay. And after this, we're going to have another fun activity. So please bear with us while you eat. You can actually, like, join the quiz as well. Okay, so, is the slides ready?
Wait, where's the slide? Okay.
Okay.
This is it, our quiz for today, woo-hoo! Guys.
All right, guys, it's quiz time. Okay, so you guys, we're gonna play quizzes today. As you can see, the link, it's on the screen. Okay, it's www.quizzes.com. And to play this game, you can actually, like, use any device, and you can enter the game code. It's 675-292.
Yeah, you can see on the chat box, one of our EO team already sent the link for
yes. And you guys can check out.
Yes, y'all better being part of this one. I mean, it will be better for y'all to, like, use another device, not device that you use for this DIY, but use the other one, so the connection will be better, isn't it, Annabelle?
Yes, guys. And also, don't forget to use your real names because there will be winners and you wouldn't want to be anonymous for this game, right? So you better use your real name, your full name. Okay, so it's very crowded now. Wow, there's 66.
60, 70.
There's 70.
Okay. Hope your connection
Come on,
are
guys,
better.
We're waiting for you. We're so excited. Okay, let me just reread the game code. It's 675-292.
Yes, Sabrina, we're waiting for you. Come on.
Yes, bestie. Okay, it's 100. It's above 100. Wow, Lucas, I'm really excited.
Impact Channel team, can MC join the game? Seriously?
Yes, please. I really want to join the game. Mm-hmm. So, guys, it's a really privilege for you because even I want to play it so bad because there will be winners. And guys, please don't forget to use your real names because there will be winners as well. Okay.
they said, someone said it brings so much high school memories. Guys, even I just know these quizzes right now. How come you guys play it when you're in high school?
Really? You never played quizzes before, Lucas?
No, this is my first time. And
no way. No way, Lucas. Okay, but now you can actually look at the game. But so sorry, you cannot actually play. So better luck next time, bestie. Wow, it's above 150.
Yes, guys. Seriously, okay, this is my first time.
Thank you so much for your enthusiasm. Please join everyone.
Come on.
We're going to like start in a few minutes. We're waiting for everyone to participate.
Come on, guys. Go join.
Come on, guys.
Our president also looking ready to join there.
Yes. Woohoo.
Yes, Miss
Tatiana
President.
Is ready. She's already inside. Wow, guys. Even our president is joining the game.
And
let's see who'll win this time, okay? If I and Lucas were in the game, I'd probably already win.
Uh-huh. I'm going to be the one.
No, Lucas. No, I think it's going to be me.
Okay. Oh, you want to start a fight right now?
Huh? No. Please, bestie. Oh, someone said, can you guys be the president? Wow, this is going to be fun. Because our president and vice president are actually in the game.
Mm-hmm.
And wow, it's going to be so much fun.
But however, our Miss President and Vice President, let's like give it a chance for the participants to win. Seriously.
Yes, you're probably going to choose the wrong answers for the sake of the winners. Oh, they're just so humbling, you guys. We totally love Tatiana and Olga so much.
It's already 170.
More than 170? Wow, okay.
Okay, come on.
Come on, because we're going to count down after this. So guys, make it quick. We're going to count.
Guys, for a better connection, you guys can also like turn your camera off. So, but with like one rule, that all of you guys must turn your camera on again after the games.
Yes. So for better internet connection, you guys can actually turn it off, turn the cameras off, and then after the quiz ends, you guys can actually turn it on again. Okay?
Yes. Come on.
Okay, I think we're gonna count down.
Okay.
From 5.
From 15, I guess, because
let's make it 15.
Okay. You go, Annabelle.
Okay, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8. Come on, guys. 7, 6, 5. Let's go, guys. 4, 3, 2, 1. One, yay!
Okay.
Okay.
This is serious.
This is going to be fun. Okay. So the first question is, what is the capital city of New Zealand? Okay. Come on, guys.
It is like almost the same with the United States. Like the name is like almost the same.
Really? Lucas, please don't spill the answers.
Oh, sorry. Oh,
okay.
I play the game.
I think Lucas is already excited.
Yes, come on, guys. Give an answer.
Come on, guys. Okay, so the options are Auckland, Wellington, Rotorua, and Dunedin. Am I spelling it right?
Sorry if we pronounce it. Okay, Marcia.
Oh, Marcia Hanuna is leading. Okay, the answer is Wellington. Good job, guys. Good job. Okay.
What's the next one? We are going to the second question.
Ooh.
Oh.
question is, how much population does New Zealand have? Is it 7 million?
I have no idea. Gypsy, where's Gypsy?
Oh, you better listen to Gypsy before, guys. Okay, 3, 2, 1. The answer is, time's up. Okay, Marcia Hanuna, you're still leading the game. Good job. Okay, for the next question.
Wait, what?
How many official languages does New Zealand have? Okay, guys, you better answer this correctly. If you were paying attention, you can actually like answer this, okay?
Mm-hmm. Where are you guys? Why like there's no one? Is my screen?
Yes, is it my screen?
Where are you guys?
Hey, okay, Marcia Hanuna is still leading.
Okay.
Okay, I guess there's some problems with the connection, but it's okay, guys.
Like, seriously, all of us from like different countries with like different problems, technical problems, anything.
Yes. Like
seriously.
It's so, okay, no, guys.
No worries, guys.
So because after this, we're going to have another Q&A session, right, Lucas?
Mm-hmm. Is it true? Are we going to give it? Like...
Is it?
Yes. Okay. Let's scroll the chat box and see the best question right there that you've seen.
Okay. So we're going to do another Q&A session. And you know, the guy, everyone who have like participate in the Q&A session will be like uploaded on our Instagram account. So you guys make sure to be involved. And okay, you guys may actually like hit the comment section.
I'm going to see which question is the best. I'm going to scroll. I'm scrolling the chat box right now to see the questions.
Okay. We'll just choose the ones like
maybe you can see
before.
You can see, Annabelle, you can see one for Michelle, and I'm going to looking for one for Gypsy right now.
Okay, I'll choose the best one for Michelle.
Mm-hmm. There are like
so many
guys. Wait, give me a second. I'm going to choose the best one. So Gypsy and Michelle, prepare yourself, besties. You're going to answer.
Prepare yourself, besties. Okay, have you found one from New Zealand? For New Zealand, I mean?
There are too many, so maybe you can start with Michelle's first.
Okay. I haven't found one yet, but you can actually start with Gypsy, though.
Maybe you can start first. I'm still looking for the question. Like, seriously, this one is like still, hi, Michelle. Thank you, Michelle, in the chat box. So I'm still scrolling up right now.
Yes.
Okay, I found one for Gypsy. So Gypsy, hi again, bestie. Am I audible?
Hello.
Okay, so Gypsy, this is like a question for you. So this is from, this one's from Nabila Jihan. Where's Nabila Jihan?
Hello, it's me.
Okay, Nabila, you're asking about like exchange field and something like that. So you can ask directly right now to Gypsy.
Hi, Gypsy. Can you tell me about the experience feels like, I mean the exchange experience feels like tell me about your exchange, please?
Yes, for sure. Thank you for your question. So if no one remembers, so I'm from New Zealand that went to Sweden. So my exchange year was in Sweden, which is pretty much on the other side of the world. So I was actually the first in the Central Plateau of New Zealand to go to Sweden. So my experiences, it's probably just like any other exchange student. It was super, super different. Different food, different atmosphere, different people, different culture, different traditions. Everything was so different. But the cool thing was that it just made so much sense. Like, I enjoyed getting to know different people, being able to live in Europe, the Nordic countries of Europe. So I was surrounded by Norway, Finland, Denmark. And I was placed pretty much in the middle of Sweden in a city called Östersund. And I was grateful enough or humbled enough to be able to have a white Christmas for the first time in my life, because in New Zealand, Christmas is during summer. So we have a summer Christmas. So that was super, super cool to be able to experience having a winter Christmas compared to a summer Christmas. Also, the food was so good. Like, I love food. People in New Zealand love food, just like every other country. So food was definitely one of my highlights, other than making so many different friends from different countries. And of course, my Swedish friends. And yeah, hopefully that answers your question.
Thank you so much, Gypsy. Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Such a good question. Thank you, Nabila. Like, Gypsy, it is like obvious that situation in New Zealand and also in Sweden is kind of different, maybe, isn't it? So it will be like so different. So it was such a good question, actually, Nabila. Thank you so much for the question. So
thank you, Nabila.
Moving on to the one for Michelle. Michelle looks excited right there.
Let's go, guys. Ask questions for Germany. Okay, there's one from Saskia. Saskia, are you there?
Yeah.
Okay. Hi, Saskia.
Hi.
Okay, we haven't actually seen you. Oh, she's here. Okay. Hello.
Hi.
We thank only see the background.
Thank you for giving me a change to can be asked to Michelle. So what is the first year reaction when you got announcement as an ambassador from Germany? Thank you.
What was my first reaction when I found out? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you for your question. I was actually really excited because I just applied. Like, I wasn't really, like, I obviously wanted to be an ambassador. Ah, there you are. What's up? Nice to see your face. So, no, it was definitely, it was really fun and exciting. I feel really honored and privileged to be in this position. But I also hope that, like, after my term, there are going to be a lot of other applicants from different countries and that Impaction is going to grow more and more. And yes. I hope that answered your question.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Saskia. All right.
Like, seriously, thank you so much, Saskia. By the way, your name is so pretty also.
Yes, so, your name is awesome. I like it, Saskia.
Mm-hmm. So, guys, Michelle, thank you so much for like giving amazing answer. And Gypsy, you also, you both are so pretty today.
Tonight.
Yes, everyone here, our ambassadors are looking very gorgeous. Like, wow, you guys must like take pictures of them, you know. And after this, we're going to have like a photo session with our ambassadors. So make your best pose.
It is the photo session. It means it is going to an end of today's session.
Yes.
Oh, I still want to be your MC, actually, but it is the end.
So. Wow, Lucas is like so enthusiastic right now. Like, he drank 5 gallons of coffee to be the MC. Like, wow.
No, because the vibes just so positive here. Like, positive vibes only here in Impactional.
True.
So. Maybe
that's why I really love, that's one thing I really love about Impactional, because of the positive vibes y'all give.
So maybe we can just take a picture, isn't it, Annabelle?
Yes, okay.
Which from our team that will, or I'm going to count. Who's going to count? Is it?
Okay. Hello, my name is Daniel. I'm from the EO team. I will be responsible to take photo of all of us. So are you guys ready to pose?
Yes, we are, Daniel.
Let's make this pose like signature pose since yesterday, I guess.
Yeah, sure. Okay, so I will be counting down. Please make sure to like stay still so your pose can be very good. Okay, so I'll count down. 3, 2, 1. Okay, give me a second. Hold your pose, please. Okay, now I'm going to move on to the second slide. Hold on. All right, let's do again in 3, 2, 1. Okay. Let me do it real quick. Hold on.
Oh, hold on, guys.
Keep smiling, guys. Smiling is good for your health, though. Okay, let's do it again. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I think we're done with the photo session. Thank you.
OMG, Gypsy's pose is like so cool.
Wow, sheesh. Yeah. We should actually do that pose.
Gypsy bestie. I guess Michelle's like signature pose is this one, and Gypsy's signature pose is this one.
Yes, wow. The cool pose.
Yeah, such a cool pose. It also looks cool, actually.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Guys, we actually are... what are we going to do actually right now, Lucas? Because I don't want to tell them. You tell them.
Okay. This is heartbreaking.
Yes, so, it's heartbreaking.
Yorobun. I mean, y'all, this is finally, we've come to the end.
I'm so sad, actually. Like, we're so happy to have y'all here. You can actually like post what we've been going through this whole session on Instagram, and don't forget to tag at Impactional. And yes, we're going to like repost your pictures. So make sure to go follow. And yeah, we're so happy.
Yeah, seriously, okay. Like these 2 days just so amazing, seriously, like 2 days that full of like job, like seriously, I'm just speechless, guys. Sorry, my English suddenly so bad.
It's okay, Lucas, we speak alien here, so it's fine, it's a safe place. You guys can actually speak from different languages in Impactional.
Yeah, we're a safe place, so yes. Guys, like keep like tag Impactional on your Instagram, like seriously.
Okay. We really,
if you guys want to being one of our ambassadors, also we're still open for all of you guys. So yeah. We're waiting for y'all to be one of to being part of Impactional, isn't it, Annabelle?
Yes, and please do keep in touch with us. Don't forget to visit us on Instagram as well, because there will be lots of ambassadors that will be taking over our Instagram, and informations will also be given on our Instagram. So thank you so much once again. We hope to see you soon. Stay safe. And
Annabelle?
Yes?
Let's look kind of professional right now.
Okay, fine. Let's end this professionally. Okay, Lucas.
So all of you guys, for the end of today's DIY and the end of all of our DIY sessions since the day one until now. We want to say thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
And see you at another event in the future by Impactional. Hope you
see
guys.
See you guys.
Yes, I am for the end. I am Lucas.
And I am Annabelle, your host for today. And see you soon. Good.